All right, part 11 for my children. This is a beautiful little village in Iceland. And Iceland is, as I just said in my last video, is the safest, best quality of life in the world now. We're all grieving. And grieving is a complex process, as I also discussed in one of my other videos. And basically, humans have three choices. The fight or flight response kicks in. You can flee the country, you can fight back and join Antifa, the anti-fascist organization, and other organizations to fight back, and pro-democracy organizations in general. And you can just blend in and remain neutral, and that's easy for us white people in this country. We can blend in while the minorities have to look over their shoulder all the time due to you know who. And I'm gonna ramble here a bit. Your dad is a fighter type, and I'm the type who would join an Antifa organization or a pro-democracy organization and get arms if necessary, and fight back. And it's just the way I am, and it's hard to change who we are. I have friends who just want to blend in and remain neutral and play it as safe as possible for themselves and their family, and that's the norm. Most people are too fearful to fight back, especially at this point. And I actually feel a little bit that way myself at this point, because the country's so far gone that fighting back may just be futile. So one has to calculate all that in one's mind. We're all going to be distrustful of each other for many years to come. We're going to be wondering, who did that person support, and the driver next to us in the other lane on the road, who did that person vote for? That, at least that's how a lot of us will be. The anger and everything is just palpable. I've been out, biking the roads, and the neighborhoods are just like ghost towns. People are like wild animals, or just like a rabbit who runs into its burrow. People are just holed up in their homes and trying to feel as safe as possible and comforting each other as best they can. And this is the most traumatic event, historical event in our lifetimes. And I've never seen anything like it in my 64 years. It's just the whole world now is fearful of dictators, and we are the superpower with nuclear weapons who kept those dictators in check. And as one commentator said on the news this morning, he said, most people, the MAGA types, they just want a leader. They don't want to have a free will. They want somebody to follow. And that is what cult members do. The commentator also said, now we just have to watch those same cult members lose their health insurance, see prices go up, see tariffs cause prices to go up, see Trump do nothing for them, see their welfare checks disappear, their Medicaid, their on and on. So that's where we are. And I will continue these little episodes for a while. And I'm thinking about returning to Sweden and fleeing the whole situation. I'm just not sure yet. And I will talk later.